You don't surrender to terrorism. You don't wave the white flag. You don't say, well, you know, we're going to change the way we do business because the terrorists might do this or might do that. No, you say that we are going to stand up to these people. They are violent thugs. They're radicalized. And we will not change the way our city grows and prospers and people live in peace and harmony. We will not change this. And we have a government that says we won't surrender to it. We have seen too many people hurt. We've now seen blood on the streets of Melbourne. This is not what Melburnians expect or want from their city, mm-hmm. and we are not going to tolerate it if I'm in government after November 24.
Okay, well, then if that's the case, do you think you could guarantee that it won't happen? If you give the police the powers that they need, if you change the environment, if you do different things with
no,
the police?
I don't think you can ever guarantee anything. But what I'm saying is you need to be the best prepared and have an attitude within government that is not to one to surrender.
Yesterday, my almost 9-year-old daughter asked me about the events in Bourke Street last Friday. And she wanted to know, you know, why would someone do that? Why would he blow up his youth? Why would he try and stab people with a knife? And it wasn't easy to answer that. And then she also said to me, could we still go shopping at Target? Because she happens to like that shop, because, of course, it occurred right outside the Target Centre. Have you had, and that was difficult again for me to answer, have you had similar conversations with your kids?
Yep. In fact, my 10-year-old asked me on Friday night when he was watching a later portion of the news and asked me what it all meant and why people would do this. It probably sounds like a very similar conversation to your daughter. And you have to explain to your own children that there are people out there in the world who want to hurt us and who don't see the world through the prism of looking after each other. And that is what it means by not surrendering, from teaching your children this kind of attitude, from engaging those who might find it difficult in being new arrivals to this country, but also saying that there is zero tolerance. And it's not just terrorism. It is this issue in Melbourne around lawlessness, whether it is gangs, whether it is repeat violent offenders, to say that this is out of control. To get back in control of this issue, we must have a government that takes it seriously.
The family of Sisto Malaspina, the man who died as a result of the attack on Friday, has decided to accept the Premier's offer for a state funeral. Do you think a state funeral is appropriate for him?
Yes, I think a state funeral is appropriate. I think he's someone who's touched a lot of Melburnians, and I think in this circumstance the city is so deeply moved by his passing that it's up to the government of the day to offer that, and I think that's a good decision.
Mm. Although we wouldn't be giving him a state funeral if he just died of a heart attack in the middle of the night, would we?
Obviously not. You might have 65,000 because that's the death rate in Victoria, but, you know, the reality is he has died in exceptionally tragic and horrifying circumstances on the city that he came to adopt and love, and the city adopted and loved him. And so I think that Melbourne wants to do that for him.
Finally, homeless man Michael Rogers, he's now been dubbed Trolley Man. People have raised, I think it's probably upwards of $120,000, $130,000. You know, he did his best to intervene. Do you think it was the right thing to do? He, you know, tried to tackle the knife-wielding man with a shopping trolley.
It's just an opinion from a politician rather than a law enforcement officer. I mean, I think anyone who sees it on the street, you want to intervene because you think you're helping the police.
Mm.
And you want to intervene because you think you're doing the right thing. And I think he thought exactly the same.
Should he get an award, do you think?
Well, probably someone who should be given some kind of accolade for the help he gave. I mean, he thought he was doing the right thing, and good on him. He thought he was doing the right thing to help. Now, whether the police obviously don't encourage it, and of course they don't. They don't want thousands of us trying to act as heroes on the street, which might hurt themselves. But in this circumstance, he has intervened, and he is, in my view, he's obviously helped the best he can, and we should say thank you to him.
I know you're a busy man. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Tom.